Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another Matt 170 concept session. Today, we're going to be talking about how to deal with negative angles on a unit circle. There's a couple of routes that you can take in order to solve negative angles, and we'll talk about both of them. The first route is, let's talk about first just like how we solve a regular positive angle, right? So we have cosine of negative 45 degrees, right? Now, let's first figure out how do we find the cosine of 45 degrees? So we know that since it's talking about cosine, we take the x value, right, of the coordinate. Now with 45, what we normally do is we go counterclockwise, right, up to the 45 degree here from 0, and then take that x value, right? Well, the first route in solving a negative angle, what we can actually do is just, instead of going counterclockwise, we just go clockwise. So we see the negative 45 degrees here, right? So instead of going counterclockwise, what we'll do is go clockwise to 45 degrees, which is this guy right here, the 315. So really, when we say cosine of negative 45 degrees, what we're really saying is the cosine of 315 degrees, which then if we look at it and we see the x value here, square root 2 over 2, and it's positive. So that's our first answer, right? And then for the second one, so for sine of negative 30 degrees, we'll do the same thing, right? So we're gonna go clockwise, right? 30 degrees. So that'll take us to 330 right there. So it's really saying the sine of 330. And then what we can do, remember we're looking for sine, so that's gonna be the y, which is negative 1/2. And that's how you solve negative angles on a unit circle. Another way that you can also kind of look at, in case you maybe forget that you have to go clockwise instead of counterclockwise, another way that you can also do it is just to subtract the number in here that's negative from 360, right? So 360 minus 45 equals 315, right? And then 360 minus 30 equals 330, which were both of those respective angles that we found. Just another way to look at it. It's still gonna be the same process though, of like whenever we have cosine, we take the x coordinate. Whenever we have sine, we take the y. That all remains consistent. It's just the direction you go on the unit circle. Hope you have a great rest of your day and good luck in your course.